Let's take a moment to clarify erythro and threo stereoisomers. So the term erythro and threo basically designates the difference between isomers where we place the chiral centers in a Fischer projection on the horizontal bonds. And so with a Fischer projection, the horizontal bonds are coming at us and the vertical bonds are going away from us. All right? And so by this designation, erythro means that our group, say bromine, for example, is on the same side as its partner bromine. Likewise, we could have another erythro isomer that has the bromines on the other side. So we have two different erythro isomers. With threo, we would have them on opposite sides of the Fischer projection. And it all depends on whether the bonds are RS, and the designation RS does not necessarily predict whether or not we'll be erythro or threo. And so we could also have another threo isomer that is the enantiomer. And so these are enantiomer pairs. Both sets are enantiomer pairs with one another. Okay? And erythro is on the left, threo here, the two enantiomer threo isomers are on the right. So the reason that I don't particularly like erythro-threo designation for these types of compounds is because as soon as you change your compound to where, say you have a BR on one side, you have a methyl on the other, and maybe an ethyl here, and suppose you have a methoxy followed by an ethyl, and say you had a propyl here. Okay, well, I generally put the parent chain, the longer chain, on the vertical axis. Now, the designation erythro and threo doesn't mean very much because all the groups are different. Originally, erythro and threo were designed for sugars, which all the way down their chain, they have OHs. Okay, and then they have their designated R groups depending on the sugar, and depending on the sugar, the stereochemistry changes. Okay, so that's where erythro and threo are most useful, but if we do have to tell which is which, we can take, say, this compound, and we can turn it into a Fischer projection. So I'm going to start with carbon 1 at the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as we would name it. And so we'll start with a methyl is carbon 1. We have two chiral centers with bromines. And then we have an ethyl group that would be part of the parent chain at the bottom. So carbons 4 and 5. Okay, now we've got to rotate everything so that it's pointed away from view. And if we do that, we have to be able to visualize the rotation of the compound that puts all the groups away. And so if we can't do the visualization in our head, say I'm going to rotate to where this bromine is on the left, and if I do that, looking at the compound, it puts the methyl away and a hydrogen at us. Bromine and hydrogen at us, methyl away. And in the next position, I have to rotate this bond. Well, really, I have to rotate this bond around so that the ethyl group is pointed away from our field of vision. And if I do that, it ends up putting this bromine on the same side as the other. So we get an erythro isomer for this. How can we check our work? Well, we can name these with R and S. If we know these are coming at us and then away, at us, away, because it's a Fischer projection, we see with group number 1, bromine is heavier than carbon. Carbon to bromine is the next heaviest. Then carbon is heavier than hydrogen. So this looks like it's S. And because hydrogen is coming at us instead of away, it's actually R in this position. Do it again for the other carbon. And if we do that, that's bromine wins again. Carbon to bromine again, carbon to carbon, and then hydrogen. Looks like it's R again, or looks like it's R because it's clockwise, 1, 2 to 3, but because hydrogen is coming at us, it's actually S instead of hydrogen going away like it should be for the naming convention. So we then have to show that carbon 2 and 3 are R and S on our original compound. So 1, 2, and I'll erase the parent chain numbers for clarity there. So 2, 3, and then 4, not drawn because it's a skeletal structure. So I've got, looks like it's S, but it's actually R because hydrogen's coming at us. So we're right on the first carbon. What about the second carbon? Let's renumber again. Bromine wins, carbon to bromine, next best, carbon to carbon, number 3, and then our hydrogen's going away from us, good, so that's 4. And that looks like counterclockwise, and it is, because hydrogen's going away, so we have RS. So we did indeed transform it correctly into our Fischer projection.